Good morning. This is Kijine, my life, my MF journey. Okay, so I'm a little discombobulated this morning. First things first, let's talk about my little precious little goldfish over here. How dare they? I got two evil goldfish that are over there. They are just evil. I think it's only one, though. It's not both of them. It's just actually just one. It's the big one, the big bully that targets this little baby here. This little one. This is the smallest one. I only have three. I have to keep taking her out of the bowl because this big shark-looking goldfish keeps attacking her. You know, and I always know when they're attacking her because when she starts like getting all, you know, frantic, and you can see the scales are missing on her side, like in the gill area, like right up, you can see the spots where they've been biting at her, and then she'll start swimming in distress, like really wiggling around in the tank, kind of flipping over, kind of not. Yeah, so I just took her out again and put her separately. I had him separately, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take his ass out and put him back. But I keep forgetting to buy the fish tank. I'm going to get one. This weekend, I'm going to get one. I'm going to go get one this weekend. A bigger one for all of them. I don't know if he's still biting them, then he's going to be put in the old tank by itself, and the two other ones are going to be put. There's a medium, a large, and this little baby. Anyway, so I've had them for 3 years, I think, maybe 3 or 4 years. That's a long time to have feeder fish, because basically that's what they are. You know, people don't really keep them as pets. They kind of feed them to other fish. Anywho, I got a busy day today. I got to go to the city with my cousin. And we also got to stop over at Princess Janae Place in the Bronx to pick up donations for Kijine's outreach for the homeless, and I'm excited about that. I am. Wasn't excited to just hang out with my cousin again, but his little shady ass. Oh no, ain't nothing little about him. Let me just say his big shady ass. Your big ass. You, Aubrey. You thought that was cute, what you did. You thought that was cute. It didn't stop me from going to work yesterday, but what it did stop is because I didn't really know that it was missing, because I have other paint. I got other makeup. Guys, let me back up. So I'm always leaving stuff at my cousin's house. Like, or if I'm in the car with him and we're hanging out, I'm always leaving something in the car by accident. And then I have to call him up and tell him to turn around and bring it back. Well, I just spent the weekend, as you know, in Jersey with them. And, I packed up everything. At least I thought I did. I packed up all of my clothes. I packed up everything. I thought. I get home. I get up the next day and I notice I dumped my whole bag on. I'm like, where is my fucking makeup bag? I opened the closet up. I said, you know what? I ain't got time for this because I was running late. I woke up at 6. I was supposed to have been actually at 5. So I was running late. So I said, well, let me just grab my old makeup and just, you know, put on something quick, real quick, and boom, beat it. Because, you know, I just got this little gig with this job. Doing healthcare, of course, which is what I love to do. But I have enough makeup to put on. All I need to do is a lash and fill in my brow. And I'm out the door. I had one compact that was, anyway, y'all don't care about makeup, but I had you know, when you don't get all the makeup out of the compact, I had one of the old compacts, so I had to scrape it, just like I had to do today, but I did anyway, and I said, I'll look for it when I come home. I get home, and I didn't even think about it, because I was so tired, you guys. I was tired. I was really, really tired yesterday, and I kind of just relaxed, and I didn't do anything. My aunt called me. She was talking to me about something that she was talking to me about. And I was like, oh, okay, well, you know. Well, actually, it's on the other video. My cousin showed you. She got her a new spouse now, you know. She's 66, and she found love. So I'm really happy for her, you know, because that's hard at 66. Shit. I don't even have love yet. So anyway, she found love. And she was calling me, you know, yesterday just to talk. So it kind of took my mind off of my makeup to look for it again. I think I mentioned to her, would you check the house to be sure? Because I'm going to check it later on here. And I didn't. I actually just went to chill out in the bed. I took a shower, ate something, relaxed. And it didn't even dawn on me, you guys. It never dawned on me at all to go check again, KG, for your makeup. Because I literally put all of my expensive makeup and brushes and eyeshadows, all the good stuff, all the expensive stuff, because I can't wear cheap makeup. I couldn't find it. Well, I didn't think about looking for it until this morning when I got up. Because I know I had to go to the city with my cousin today and stuff. So, you know, she want to look a little cute, a little something-something. You know what I'm saying? She just want to look a little something-something. You know? So, I said, let me go grab my makeup after I showered. Went in there. I didn't see it. I looked in the hallway closet. I didn't see it. I went in the coat closet, which is the closet that I cleaned out for the donations that I'm going to receive today. I cleaned out half of one of my closet because that's all the space I have. My other closets are packed to capacity. So, with my own clothes and things. So, yeah. That closet there, I looked in there and I said, it's not hanging up. And I started panicking. Because, you know, a girl likes to look her best when she steps out the door. Going to, you know, if you're going to leave Staten Island to go anywhere else, you need to get this together. You know, even if it's a light little poof, get it together. And I didn't have my stuff. So what I did was panicked like I normally do and started typing, you know, to him. And he didn't respond. In Aubrey's fashion, of course, because he thinks that bothers me when he doesn't respond anymore. If I leave something, like if he don't respond right away, he likes to see me grovel and beg and be like all frantic and crazy. She always have a backup plan, honey. So I use that little compact, didn't have nothing in it. I just took my finger, wrapped it around there, put it on the brush. Because, of course, I have extra brushes here. I'm no fool now. Instead of using the eyelash glue, I used bonding glue today on my lashes. Blink, blink, blink. Blink, blink, blink. And just filled in my brow. I had an extra pencil here. There you go. I'm going to put a little lip gloss on. I'm good to go. Now I just got to take off this pajama shirt and put on my regular shirt and I'll be ready to go. And my sneakers. So I'm ready to go. But yeah, I just was like, I was panicking. But I knew he wasn't going to respond. So I said, let me go ahead after I send these messages and try to make it work. And I think I did. I think I made it work pretty good. What y'all think? Yeah? Anyway, Aubrey, I love you down, but you still shady because you had my makeup all yesterday. And I remember, this is the shade, y'all. I remember walking out of the house and for some reason, he mentioned it like three times to me. He says, yeah, well, I hope you got everything because I don't want you to be blaming me later on about you left something. So I'm like, okay. And I paid him. I was like, Charlie, I got all my stuff. He said it in Jersey. He said it in the car, and he said it on the way out of the car when we got in the front. I'm like, why does he keep mentioning if I left anything? Because he seen it when he went back in the house. And I was like, Aubrey's in the bathroom. He's always in the bathroom for an hour at least when he's in the bathroom. I said, so y'all just come on and take the stuff back in the house and wait for Aubrey. Child, point is, I had never brought my Louis upstairs, my little Louis bag. I had never brought it upstairs. It has all of my makeup in it. He saw that bag yesterday. He had to, because Aubrey knows his room. It's his bedroom. I slept in his room. He saw that bag full of makeup. He ain't bothered to tell me, though. See, that's the shade of it all. So, that's all right, Aubrey. I got you today, boo. I got you. Remember, you got to spend several hours with me today. I got you, boo. But anyway, you guys, back to other things. So, yeah, this week, because I have to work tomorrow, but tomorrow I'm going to do outreach when I come home. It's going to be in the evening. I don't really care for doing outreach in the evenings, simply because, honestly, it's dangerous. And I'd be by myself, you know what I mean? But I believe in what I do for people, for the homeless community. I believe in it. I was there, you know? I was also homeless at one time in my life, so I know what it's like. I know what it's like for people to just walk past you like you're nothing. You know, I never had to sleep on the street, although I know friends who have. I never had to sleep on the street. However, I did. Believe me, that's another whole chapter. We'll get to that one day. I think that is an interesting piece of the puzzle. One of the pieces of the puzzle of my life that I'd like to share with you guys. I'll probably do that tomorrow, as a matter of fact. Tomorrow evening, I'll talk about it. But yeah, I know what it's like to be homeless. So I know the experience. I know what they go through. I know how they're ashamed. Like my friend Stacy that I just met was homeless. She's such a sweet lady. Sweet girl. And I don't know, I just smile when I see her, because she's all, you know, she's a little hyper. She's always, you know, she's always moving when she's talking to you. And she's always trying to get money out of me. But she's very grateful for everything that she gets, you know, any hygiene products. But she's the one who really touched my heart when she told me that the men in the stores, like the guys that own the stores up there on that strip, that they don't let her in there because of her hygiene. When she said they wouldn't let her in because of her hygiene, I felt so bad, man. My heart just wanted to cry. But I don't want nobody to see me cry. So I was just like, I got you, baby. I gave her a hug. And I said, when I see you again, I'm coming looking for you. But when I see you again, I'm going to, you know, give you some feminine hygiene products and some soaps and lotions. And I found her and I did. But I want to continue that with her, because I want her to continue her hygiene. She's a woman. And like I said before, women have special needs, different needs than men, you know, and they need to be met. So I'm on my way out there today to pick up some more stuff, some more things. And then tomorrow, definitely Saturday, if I don't do outreach tomorrow evening, it's because I'm thinking twice about going out there at night. Because when I go out there at night, guys, it's a lot of guys out there, and they're huddled in corners and shit, and the lights are off in a lot of these spots. I don't know if that's purposely done by the police or if that's purposely done by the people that are hanging out, but why are the lights out in right there where y'all hang out at? Like, and then I have to, and there's women and men over there, and I have to walk past them and walk into the crowd and give out these things by myself. It's not safe. One, me being a woman. Two, me being a black trans woman. And I say that because we are on the top of the list for some reason for murder. They want to kill us off. Black men, that is. And I've said that before. So, yeah, it's very dangerous. I don't know if for sure if I'm going to be there tomorrow night. But I'll definitely be there Saturday. Over the weekend. I'll do it over the weekend. Yeah. But during the day. you know, when there's daylight, when there's sunlight. Other than that, you guys, I'm okay. Everything's a good day so far. It's a great day. Starting off really good. And I hope you guys are staying safe with all the protesting that's going on. Daniel Prude in Rochester, New York, was murdered actually before George Floyd, and his death was swept under the rug. People didn't know that. The video came out and started surfacing recently about this black man's death, George Daniel Prude. And yeah, they put a spit mask over his face and then suffocated the man. Like, really? So cops are playing real dirty over there. In Rochester. So they're actually protesting right now, and the protesters has actually been there, you guys, for days now, for a few days or whatever, and they've camped out there to make sure that we keep, you know, making the crowd bigger. Just, we need more awareness. We need more people coming to the scene over there by the courthouse. That's where they're protesting. But the officers, from what I just got, the latest I just got from Britton, who is a leader in the LGBTQ community, he's out there protesting, and he told me, well, I saw on his post recently that the cops, he took pictures, and I should actually post those too, or just share his post. But their cops actually covered their freaking names up, their name tags up on their badges. Yeah, so you know if they covered their name tags, that means that their cameras are not on. No matter how many times they tell you that they're on, if they covered their name tag, and they got Billy Club, they got those big clubs, and their tags, name tags are covered, that means that their camera right here that they have on them is off. It's off. So basically, they can get away with murder if no one's can identify these motherfuckers. So they're trying not to be identified. They're playing real dirty, you guys, with this movement. Okay, so that's what's going on with that. There's a lot of stuff that was happening when I was protesting in Manhattan. A lot. Like, we would be in the street, literally in the street, like you're supposed to, peacefully protesting, which is what we're legally can do. We can legally do that. There's laws to protect us for peacefully protesting. But we couldn't peacefully protest because behind us, cars are running us over. The last time it happened, I was in New York, it literally happened before I joined the protest. So somebody had got ran over. So I joined the protest when it came down towards Central Park. But it happened on, so instead of happening on 59th, it happened on 49th Street in Manhattan. White guys jumped in a car. The police escorted them to the car, blocked the protesters from them, and they drove through a crowd. That was the last time. That was the last time for me. That was enough for me because, listen, I've seen more than that happen while I was out there. I've seen the police beat us in the head with freaking those clubs, arresting everybody. I didn't get arrested, but most of the protests that I went to was peaceful. And during the day, but as you saw the other night, there is sometimes when I've been at night. I've been out there protesting at night, and at night it gets really, really dirty. And it gets dirty during the daytime, but at night it gets really dirty. So I've always tried to avoid it at night, but sometimes I just couldn't. And yeah, I've seen a lot of shit. And I'm tired of the cops getting away with the abuse. Mentally, it was fucking me up, draining me. I already live with like anxiety and depression, but depression doesn't really happen to me mostly. It's the anxiety that gets to me, and then it turns into the depression. However, it really started messing with my head, seeing this abuse happen over and over and over, and then watching me support my own people in this movement at my age. There's a lot of young people that I'm so proud of that are out there. The movement is now run, actually, by young people. It's not the older people running the movement. It's the younger people running the movement. I'm very proud of that. So they're carrying, you know, on the torch, which is wonderful. What was I saying? I've seen a lot of shit, and like I said, it's too much. It was getting to be too much for me, and then getting away with too much. When you see all of this happen, and you walking into your feet got blisters, which was me. You marching and walking into your feet got fucking blisters. And then the next day, I mean, it's happened several times, but one time when it happened, it was literally the very next day, this girl named Ayana in Wisconsin was jumped by about like 30 black people, men and women. That pissed me off. And I know people, what you're going to say, don't compare the two. Don't compare the two. Use that line for white people when y'all say that. Some people other than us, my community. I'm black. So what I'm going to say is to you, once again, I do compare the two. I do say to you, how can you do this to us? Because all black lives matter. And if you say all black lives matter. And I'm out here busting my ass protesting and marching and putting my life on the line and being on the front fucking line. Anything could happen to me. The next day you drunk one of my sisters? The next day you killed one of my sisters? The next day you shoot one of my sisters? Come on. No. That's bullshit. So I get pissed about that. I really, there's no in between for me. It should not happen. And so since they still can go in the crowds and march, but when that march is over, you know, if you happen to see a trans woman that you are maybe attracted to, and you can't take it that you are attracted to her, so your masculinity in your mind is threatened, and you take it out on her instead of just like accepting the fact or acknowledging the fact that yes, she's a beautiful girl. I'm attracted to her. She might not be what I'm looking for, but damn, she's really beautiful. And minding your business and walking the fuck away like a normal human being. But instead, you'd rather catch a case behind murdering one of us. Idiots. So, we're not going to talk about that, because that shit pisses me off. And that was one of the reasons, you know. You know, those are a couple of the reasons, but I'm not marching anymore. I'm not protesting anymore. Not for the BLM movement, but I'm definitely going to continue to share. I'm going to continue to post. I'm going to continue to bring awareness to the movement, because I have to, period. It's my duty as a black woman. You know, we got to see legislation. We need to see these motherfuckers make laws now and change things. This is not going to just be a massacre or some, you know, modern day genocide, and then it just moves all over. For all the lives that are being lost, trust and believe me, this will not be going down in vain. Their lives will not go down in vain. We're working towards a better future for all of us to live together. The way that things were set up all this time was wrong, and we're undoing it now. That's what's happening. So that's pretty much it, you guys. That's pretty much it. Sorry about the music. I don't know. I do not own the rights to none of the music in the background. Thank you. So it's been nice talking to you. I love you. Stay safe. Stay blessed. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that like button right there. I know you see it. It's right there. Hit it. And hit that subscribe button for me. I love y'all. Ladies, stay safe, please. Men, black men especially, please stay safe. I love y'all. I love my black men. I love my black women. I love my trans sisters and my trans brothers. Stay safe.